one and all, for a destructive vibe. And your excellencies, your majesties, this is especially for you. For I know that you decide our fate. And slaying. I have a story for you that involves three Daddy Warriors.
Daddy Warriors.
The first was a young man, a handsome young man, a fine young man, a good warrior. His name was Seamus. Seamus! He fought on the fields at Battlemore, and he got shot in the neck with an arrow at Battlemore.
Oh.
And he went to heaven.
Isn't that what it pertains for?
And in heaven, St. Peter said, Seamus, we're so happy to see you.
Exactly what you're
supposed to say, right? You go through the woods, down this path, and you will receive your eternal reward. So off goes Seamus. He goes left. He goes right. He goes down the path to receive his eternal reward. And there's a cottage. A small cottage. A modest cottage. But a cottage nonetheless. He says, hold on. I get a cottage in heaven. This is wonderful. He opens the door to his cottage. He looks around the room. It's modestly appointed. It has some furniture. It has a stock larder. He feels good about this. His eternal reward's looking pretty good. And then he notices there's a curtain in the corner. And he thinks, that is strange. Why would they put a curtain in the corner? So he takes one more step in, and the doors of the cottage close behind him forever. And the curtain falls to the ground. And behind the curtain is the ugliest woman he's ever seen. She is squat to the ground. She has short, speckled hair. She's beady little eyes and buck teeth. She's so ugly. Bitch! Seamus screams out in pain. Scream! Ah! And he falls down, and a voice comes down from on high, and it says, Seamus, for all the deeds that you have done in life, you are doomed to spend eternity with this woman. And thus we leave Seamus to his fate. The next one to come into contact with the assassin's blade is a man named Ilo Defoe. Ooh. Ilo Defoe was having a beautiful dinner when a man slit his throat and he died. But he went to heaven. And when he was in heaven, he saw St. Peter and said, Ilo, we've been waiting for you. Go down this path and you will receive your eternal reward. So he goes down the path. He goes left, he goes right, and eventually he comes to a manor house. And I was like, yeah, all right, this is what I'm talking about. My eternal reward. He walks into the manor house. It's fabulous, fabulously appointed. It's wonderful. He sees tapestries, he sees chandeliers. He's very impressed. But then he sees there's a curtain in the corner.
Uh-oh.
And he says, what's that about? So he takes one more step in. And the doors of this manor house close behind him forever. And the curtain falls to the ground. And it's the most ugliest woman he's ever seen. She's rail thin, skin and bones. Long nose. Right. Orange hair that's all over the place. Knobby knees and a shrill voice. And he's shocked. And then the voice comes down from on high and says, Ilo Defoe, for the sins you have committed in this world, you are doomed to spend eternity with this woman. No! And we leave Ilo to his fate. Now finally, there was a warlord who did make war on behalf of his king. His name was Gareth Thorkelson, and he had done a good and stout job in that position. And when he came to sup with the king at the end of the war, he took a sip of his pea soup, and he fell dead, for he had been poisoned by a rival.
Oh.
But he went to heaven!
Yay!
And he he gets up and he goes, and there's St. Peter. St. Peter says, here. Follow this path. And down this path, you will receive your eternal reward. So he goes down the path. He goes left. He goes right. And then he sees a tower house in the middle of a clearing. A beautiful tower house, 50 feet in the air. He said, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I love this. Oh, this is, I totally deserve this. That's what he says. So he walks in, and there's a winding staircase all the way up. He goes to the second floor. There's tabs, there's candles. There's all manner of decoration on the wall. He's marveling at his eternal reward. And then he gets to the top, and there is the double doors to his bedchamber. And he opens the double doors, and it's this huge bed with furs. There's a writing desk. He's got a salon. It's the works. It's so great. And he's just speechless. And then he sees there's a curtain in the corner. He steps in, and the doors of his bedroom close behind him forever. And the curtain falls to the ground. And a voice comes over from on high that says, wait, back up. There's a woman. The most beautiful woman he's ever seen. The most beautiful woman he's ever seen. Long flowing hair. Beautiful pools of water for eyes. Just his dream woman. You know, couldn't get any better. Then the voice came on high and says, Helen of Troy, for the sins you've committed in this planet, you will determine your fate with this man. And Helen of Troy falls to her knees screaming, no! And that is the tale of these Doughty Warriors. That's awesome.